Okay. You know, one of the things that as we have other applications, and once we've done a study of compound propositions and study of words, one of the things that we could do is consider. See if I can actually spell today. I can never spell. Anyways, if we're considering several compound propositions together rather than one, you know, an example would be, let's take something simple. Let's say that we have two simple propositions, and I'm going to consider, say, the biconditional and say conjunction. So if I would look at this, this would be true, true, false, false, and then true, false, and true, false, and then that would be true implies true is true. False implies anything is vacuously true, right? Because if your hypothesis, your condition hasn't been met, whoops, I'm thinking of implication. For the biconditional, it's just the comparator. So true and true are the same, false and false are the same. True implies false is false. They are not the same thing. False implies true is also false. If it would be implication, which I just talked about, true implies true is true. False implies anything is always going to be true, no matter what. And so that's called a vacuous truth, because if your hypothesis hasn't been met, who cares, right? That doesn't have to be worried about. So you can't have lied. The entire statement can't be wrong if you don't even move into the rest of the statement. So it's just vacuously true. And the only way it can be wrong is if you meet your hypothesis, you move in and you mess up the inside. So if that's false, that's false. And so we have this conjunction, false dominates. So wherever I have a false, if I lie anytime, it's a lie. I only have a truth when everybody's true. So if I would look at a system like this, let's say I had these three compound propositions. The idea of a system specification is, let's say that P and Q have some sort of particular meaning. Let's say that P and Q are, my name's Mark. Let's say P denotes I'll eat peas, and then Q denotes I asked a question in class. Right, and so those are simple propositions, and then the if and only if would be, well, somebody says this for a system, which is, I don't know, the system of my class, it's whatever, say it's a computer system, it doesn't really matter. So one person says, you know what must happen, what must be true, is that I eat peas if and only if I've asked a question in class. So that's something that they say. So that's specification one. And then the next person says, no, I have another specification. My specification, I believe, has to be true, is I eat peas and I asked a question in class. And you're like, okay, yeah, that's fine. That's your specification. And the third specification that somebody comes up with is, you know what, I notice that if I eat peas, then I will ask a question in class. And so you would have that particular one. Now the question is, if these are three specifications, if this is specification one, and this is specification two, is this specification three, is it consistent? Now, the idea of consistent is the idea is it ever possible for all of these to work? Do all the specifications work, which is be true at some same time? And which is really what I'm talking about is in some row. Is there a row where all three of these things happen at the same time? Well, if I look at this, if I look at the first row, I notice, yep, it works in the first row, but I look in the second, no. I look in the third, well, only the third specification is true. If I look at the last row, I notice the first specification is true, the third set, but the second one is not. But if this happens, yeah, you know what? If you tell me that you require eating peas if and only if ask a question, if you require eating peas and asking a question, if you require if you eat peas, then you ask a question, if you require those three things, it will work in this event. And so if that ever happens, you say, yes, it is consistent. And so these three specifications, so for our example, is consistent. Well, what if we had a different one? What if we would go through here and say, okay, I've got P and Q, true, true, false, false, and true, false, and true, false. I've still got, say, P if and only if Q. And so I've got true, false, false, true. Let's say that I still have P and Q, which is true, false, false, false. And then let's say somebody else says, no, 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 I need the specification P exclusive or Q, which is false, true, true, false. And we look at this and say, all right, fine. So what you're telling me, so for example, number two, somebody says that it's important that eating peas if and only if you ask a question and you eat peas and ask a question. And then the third person says it's absolutely required for specification three that you eat peas exclusively ask a question, which means you can't do both at the same time, but you have to do one of them. And when I look at this, for each of these, this is not all true. This entire row is not all true. This entire row is not all true. And this entire row is not all true. And so when I look at this, it's like it never happens. It never happens that these three things can be met at the same time. So for this example, it never happens that all three of these specifications, forget P, are met at the same time. And so that's what we say is these are inconsistent. Now, doing consistent or inconsistent systems, normally when you look at this, you're not going to see truth tables. Truth tables help, though. They help you figure out why and when things happen. You get good enough at reasoning and verbalizing, you start to be able to have discussions. And so really, if we would look at the real big catching point of this problem is obviously this one, and this one is a huge catching point, right? Because they're negations of each other. So you would sit there and say, hey, you have a specification that eating peas and asking questions are tied. So biconditional says you're going to do both or you're not going to do both. You can't do one or the other. That's what biconditional means. Now, the other person says it needs to be exclusive or, which means you never do both or you never skip it. You do one or the other, but not both. Well, those two things are in direct contradiction to each other. It's impossible for those to meet. And if they're impossible to meet, it's an inconsistent. So those two specifications right there, circled in red, are huge, right? It can't happen. You're never going to have these be true at the same time. And so that's one problem. It also works that, hey, look, those also break. Those aren't true at the same time because and says it needs both, and exclusive or says both can't happen at the same time. So that's another breaking point. And so you don't necessarily you don't have to make truth tables. You can make it verbal in nature. The words I just said, this cannot be consistent. This is inconsistent because conjunction requires that both of them be true, but exclusive or never allows. It says but not both. That's literally what exclusive or means. Inconsistent. Those don't work. And then you could just literally say those words and be done. You don't need any truth table. So, but again, like the last example, truth tables can help you to reason and see and discuss all the possibilities. It's easy when we have small numbers like two or three. You're going to have to stay in verbal discussions when you have much more than that.